In this month's episode, Adriana Diaz lands home success in Guaynabo, German stars dazzle in Montreux, and Portugal hosts first ever ITTF Challenge Plus event. Welcome to the ITTF monthly Pongcast brought to you by Nittaku. Each month, Nittaku is giving away a piece of gear to one lucky viewer. For your chance to win, just answer this month's Pongcast question. Which country has won every men's singles title at the Pan American Cup since its formation? To enter the draw, comment your answer below the Pongcast post on ITTF's Facebook page and remember to share the episode with your friends. The winner will be picked at random. We start off the month's recap in Guaynabo, Puerto Rico, where the finest players from the North and Latin American continents met from February 1st through the 3rd at the Universal 2019 ITTF Pan American Cup. The quarterfinal stage of the men's singles tournament played out as expected, with the top four seeded players all progressing. But there was a mini upset in the semifinal match in the lower half of the draw, as USA's Kunik Jod defeated second seed and 2017 champion Gustavo Tsuboi 4-2. In the top half of the draw, Brazil's Hugo Calderano posted a 4-2 win against Paraguay's Marcelo Aguirre. Winner in 2018, Hugo Calderano made it back-to-back Pan American Cup titles, coming out on top against Kunik Jod by a 4-1 scoreline, meaning that Brazil remains the only country to claim the gold medal in the category. In a cracking encounter at the top of the women's singles draw, it was Canada's Mo Jong who came through the battle of champions, with the 2018 winner eliminating 2017 gold medalist Lily Jong in a thrilling quarterfinal contest. One round later, and it was the turn of Lily Jong's national teammate Wu Yue to depart, with the USA representative falling just short against Puerto Rico's very own Adriana Diaz in the last four. With the backing of the home crowd, local hero Diaz was simply unstoppable, storming to a 4-1 victory in the final to become the first host nation player to win Pan American Cup silverware. Let's watch the closing moments leading up to Adriana Diaz's gold medal finish in Guaynabo.
Virtualmente imposible de contestar, y sigue poniendo presión y sigue produciendo el esfuerzo de Adriana, que coloca el marcador en un tremendo avance, 9-7.
Adriana está, es una jugadora tranquila, pero ahora está sabiendo usar la fanaticada a su favor muy bien, y yo creo que eso está estresando mucho a Mozart.
No quiero estresar al público, pero Adriana está a 2 puntos de lograr el campeonato.
De ser la reina del evento. A ver, ella lo es como quiera. Oh. Y ahora se quedó muy larga y ancho. Aunque fue preparando muy bien la jugada para ese último golpe, no pudo ser. 9-8 el marcador.
Vamos a ver si, como estoy acostumbrando, Adriana logra cerrar el set y el campeonato.
Siempre acentuando el nivel de Mo Zhang. Ha estado en esta y en mil
competencias.
Fallando largo. 10-8. Adriana alivia un punto de llevarse la victoria frente a una super rival que le ha correspondido en este último partido.
Esta ha sido una batalla campal. No se puede dar el hecho de que Adriana ha ganado. No se gana hasta que se hace el punto número 11 en el cuarto set. Hay que seguir jugando.
10 le sirve a 8 de pie el público, aunque en silencio. La secuencia continuando, bastante prolongada, derechas, izquierdas. Excelente otra vez el contragolpe. Oh. Abierto el disparo del punto número 9. Seguimos viendo un gran nivel de ambas jugadoras.
Mucha decisión de ambas jugadoras, pero más de la jugadora Mozart, que está a ley de perder, pero sigue siendo agresivo.
Adriana, la selección de tiro me encantó porque le sirvió hacia arriba. Obviamente Mozart la identificó y logró hacer una banana y empezar la jugada ofensiva.
Silencio impresionante cuando hay sobre 6.000 fanáticos aquí congregados para ver este evento. Adriana tratando de buscar el punto.
¡Oh! Y se acabó con estrella.
Adriana, Puerto Rico, otra gran victoria.
de manera espectacular, y somos muchos los que estamos emocionados de la manera que Adriana.
For the second year running, Montreux, Switzerland welcomed Europe's elite players for the CCB ITTF 2019 Europe Top 16 Cup from February 2nd through the 3rd. Former champion Li Jie was one of the first major casualties in the women's singles event, with the number 4 seed losing out to Poland's Natalia Partyka. And round one also saw an early exit for Sweden's Matilda Ekholm falling to German opponent Nina Mittelham. Bronze medalist in 2018, but there was no spot beyond round two for Romania's Elisabetta Samara after the number 3 seeded player was shown the door by 2-time runner-up Patricia Solia. Yeah! The German star was just as impressive against Austria's Sofia Polkanova, producing a 4-2 win over the top seed to reach the final. Finishing on the third step of the podium and gaining a spot at the Women's World Cup in the process, Sofia Polkanova held the upper hand against Natalia Partyka, who finished fourth on her top 16 debut. But the top prize was reserved for Patricia Solia, recovering from a 3-game deficit to see off 2018 champion Bernadette Such 4-3 to lift the trophy for the first time. Eye-catching results right from the word go. The men's singles also saw major upsets. Seated second for the draw, Sweden's Mattias Falk suffered a 4-2 defeat at the hands of experienced Greek defender Panayotis Giannis. And seventh seed Marcos Freitas also succumbed to an early exit against number 11 seed Daniel Habison. An impressive start, and Daniel Habison put in another fine display in round two, knocking Simone Gauzy out in 6 games to reach the semifinals. Go! However, the Austrian met his match in 4-time champion Vladimir Samsonov, while the upper section of the draw saw Dmitry Ovtcharov squeeze past defending champion Timo Boll in an exciting affair.
He's got the edge.
Beaten in the last 4, Boll ended his campaign on a positive note, sealing his place at the Men's World Cup with a 4-3 win at Habison's expense, and the gold medal match also required the full 7-game distance to find a winner. Trailing Samsonov 8-10 in the deciding game of the final, Ovtcharov held his nerve, picking up the next 4 points in a row to claim his 5th men's singles trophy at the event. Here's how Dmitry Ovtcharov added title number 5 to his collection.
A miscue from Ovtcharov. Light at the end of the tunnel for the Belarusian. It's Vladimir Samsonov now with a couple of match point opportunities. Title points here for the 5th seed. Lion-hearted from Ovtcharov there to save the first. Crowd shaking their head in disbelief at his courage. Can he do it again? Samsonov here with a 2nd championship point. No way! What a point from Ovtcharov. He's not done yet. Hammers this one away with all of his might, but it comes back. Almost. Bet he was pleased to see that one sink down beside the table and not clip a faint edge. Deadlock again. Deep breath time all around the arena. Well, he saved two match points. Now he's got one on his own terms. And it's on his own serve, more poignantly. It's a fifth Europe Top 16 Cup title.
Table tennis continues to produce impressive viewing numbers in China, with a 41.9% of the country's population having watched the sport on TV in 2018. Over 500 million unique viewers tuned in to watch table tennis over the course of the year, and numbers were up on the previous year, with the cumulated audience up from just over 600 million to 768 million people, the fourth most watched sport overall behind football, basketball, and volleyball. Table tennis was by far the main racket sport to watch for people in China, outpacing tennis and badminton by some distance. The International Table Tennis Federation is excited to confirm the 12 destinations that have been selected to host the 2020 ITTF World Tour events. More prize money, greater fan engagement, and a better TV spectacle for a worldwide audience. The 2020 ITTF World Tour is set to be the biggest in the history of table tennis. As before, the successful two-tier system consisting of six ITTF World Tour Platinum and six regular ITTF World Tour events remains. The six Platinum events will be staged in Germany, Qatar, Japan, China, Australia, and Austria, while the six regular events will be hosted in Hungary, Hong Kong, Korea Republic, Czech Republic, Bulgaria, and Sweden. The ITTF is seeking a long-term strategic partner to assist in the remodeling of table tennis's commercial rights and boost the sport's global growth. The new partner will be key to driving revenue increases while further building the professionalism in table tennis, creating a compelling structure of events, and improving the promotion of a sport in ever-increasing demand and brimming with untapped potential. Less than 6 months from now, history will be made when the very first ITTF World Veterans Tour kicks off in August. Following a bidding process which initially saw 16 cities shortlisted, a total of six events are confirmed to run through 2019 in the cities of Shenzhen, Innsbruck, Townsville, Fort Lauderdale, Doha, and Cardiff. February also saw new territory for the ITTF Challenge Series, with the first ever ITTF Challenge Plus event taking place in Lisbon, Portugal from February 15th through the 17th. Very much making a name for herself in Portugal, China's Fan Siqi produced a stunning performance in the round of 16 to see off second seed Hitomi Sato. However, there was to be no spot in the last eight for top seed Liu Shiwen, who suffered a shock 4-2 loss against 11th seed Hina Hayata at the summit of the draw. Gaining a huge confidence boost from her fantastic display, Hayata went on to post further successes in her following two encounters to set up a meeting with Honoka Hashimoto in an all-Japanese final. In a contest of attack versus defense, it was the positive impetus of Hina Hayata that prevailed, recovering from 0-2 down to beat her national colleague by a 4-3 margin. Over in the men's singles draw, it was Denmark's Jonathan Groth whose name was in the spotlight in round one, but for the wrong reasons, with the second seed departing to Japanese qualifier Shunsuke Togami. However, it was another unseeded player in China's Liu Yabo who stole the show in the lower section of the draw, achieving a superb comeback from 0-3 down to beat 19th seed Yukiya Uda 4-3 to book his spot in the semifinals. Third seed and fellow compatriot Liang Jingquan eventually brought Liu Yabo's campaign to a halt in the penultimate round before doing the same to top seed Lin Gaoyuan at the final hurdle, needing just five games to secure his place at the top of the medal podium.
Oh, well. Liang Jingquan is the champion here at the Portugal Open.
Forming a fine partnership, China's Lin Gaoyuan and Liu Shiwen took the honors in the mixed doubles event, beating second seeds Lubomir Piszte and Tatiana Kukukova in straight games. China also took home two further gold medals in the doubles with Cao Wei and Xu Yingbin getting the better of Japan's Shunsuke Togami and Yukiya Uda in the men's doubles final. While over in the women's doubles final, Fan Siqi and Yang Huijing recovered from a 2-game deficit to see off Hungarian opponents Dora Madaras and Sandra Pergel. Before we go, it's the moment you've been waiting for, Match Point featuring the best point of February.
Standout rally, best rally of the match by a long way. Pokunova coming out on top that time. Things deadlocked again to the scoreboard.
That's it for this month's Pongcast. I've been your host, Adam Bobrow, and be sure to tune in next month as we review even more table tennis action from around the world.